oftentimes people think about wellness as the absence of illness, but what we're really finding is that the way in which we live, the way in which we feel, the way in which we relate to one another and to ourselves is instrumental not only in our behavior and our minds, but also in our physical and biological health, and really reclaiming that space for wellness in a new way that supports ourselves and others in flourishing. That's the true path. One sort of pitfall, which is easy to stumble into in today's world, is that the readable accessibility of relationships, of communications, of very superficial ways of interacting with one another can easily supersede and push away the deeper things that we can notice, these sorts of emotional glimmers. So we really want to shift from having emotions that are about what things look like and what we do to emotions that are about ideas and beliefs and identities that are transcending in service of something bigger. This can be done in myriad ways. For some people, things like yoga or embodied movement and breath movement are a pattern that can really lead to these kinds of well-being, in part because they leverage and manage the physiology of the body, the breath, the movement, in the service of the kind of after effects or the downstream effects that this has on the brain and on the mind.